This is your lineup here for the gubernatorial race now in the general election. Republican Duke Iona, Independent Mufi Hannemann, and Democrat David Ige. We have Mufi Hannemann here with us this morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Happy Statehood Day.
Happy Statehood Day. Absolutely. Glad that a lot of people have the day off. All right, so let's talk about how your candidacy moves forward. Now we are into the three primary opponents you have facing you. Everybody's forming their teams together. Let's talk about that. Who you're partnering with and why you think that creates the best team.
Well, Les Chiang is the only person running for lieutenant governor or governor that has served in the military. 30 years of being an Air Force colonel, where his last assignment was 8,000 employees and a $1 billion operating budget in Okinawa. And when you couple that with the CEO type of experience that I bring as mayor of the 13th largest city, the CEO positions in the private sector, like being head of the Hawaii Lodging and Tourism Association, and the nonprofit world, overseeing programs like the Pacific Century Fellows. We bring the total package of executive leadership, of being a manager, of overseeing large numbers of employees and many resources that will enable us in many ways to hit the ground running.
So let's talk about what happened in this primary election. With what happened with Senator Ige up against Governor Abercrombie, surprising to a lot of people that it was such a large gap. What do you glean from what happened, and what does that mean for your candidacy moving forward?
Well, kudos to Senator Ige, who did a wonderful job being able to amass the kind of victory that he did. But now as we go into the general election, it's a whole new set of dynamics. More people vote in a general election. About 100,000 new voters will come out, many of them independents. You pointed out this morning, you run as a tandem, so it's a team that you're presenting. And thirdly, you need to make the transition from saying, not saying what is wrong with the president incumbent and his administration, but now you have to articulate a vision, a message, a plan that's going to affect people out there, their families, the kupuna, young folks and the like. Yesterday we were in Pune, and we saw firsthand what people are going through and the concerns that they have. And for Les and I, we were talking about how do we avert these kind of situations in the future in terms of the recovery period, the albizia trees, the invasive species, you know, the lack of electricity, and then the farmers were hurt big time during this whole ordeal. So there's a lot of issues there.
Speaking of, I just wanted to mention real quick, you said you just came back from Pune, you got a chance to take a look at what happened there. Important for you to head out there for a little bit?
Yes, it is. Yeah. I called Mayor Kinoy after it happened, and I said, you know, what do you need, and so forth. And of course he said, you know, first thing he said, we need ice. And so that's always important, and it was really heartening to see, and heartwarming to see a lot of people just step up to the plate. We have to continue to do that. But most importantly, I think, as someone that wants to be the governor of the state of Hawaii, you need to also look at these things, not just from a natural disaster standpoint. Right. I had a lot of experience as the mayor doing that, but also in terms of some of the state-related issues that need help from the county, from people in general, and the private stakeholders.
Well, no surprise, hitting the ground running as we hit this next phase for the race for governor. Thank you, gubernatorial candidate Mufi Hannemann, for joining us this morning.
Pleasure to be here.
Good luck. All right. Still ahead, a recap of the day's morning headlines. We'll be right back.